Our third chef's tasting event. I'm going to tell you why we're doing this. I am a chef, and we have a very set menu at our regular cafe. So this gives us a chance to really show people what raw foods can be, and also let me stretch my wings a little bit as far as a culinary art. We're going to have a 5-course meal today. We're starting out with a lobster mushroom chowder. When I first did this recipe and I submitted my menu to the Suffolk County Health Department, they had a bit of a problem with it because they're like, well, lobster, where are you going to get your lobster? I was like, no, it's lobster mushrooms. It's a variety of mushrooms that grows in the Northwest. It's actually a double mushroom. It starts out with some mushroom called the brussle. And then it's invaded by another mushroom, a parasitic mushroom, that changes the structure and the color and the taste and turns it into this wonderful lobster mushroom that gives it its distinct red color and kind of really a seafoody taste. So that is what you've got going on there.
Mm. That's a great description.
All right.
Wow.
All right.
And the little stars?
Oh, yes, the little stars. They are hazelnut oyster crackers.
Hey folks, we need this quick to see how this goes. It's really good. It's really good. That's right. Yeah, it's pretty good, right? Yeah.
My tribute to winter. So what you have there are some baby gold beets, and there was some heirloom apples, some Wixen apples, and of course, as most of you probably know, heirloom vegetables are very important these days as seeds are being snatched up by corporations. So it's very important that we start collecting our seeds and really getting back to the original plants that were. So these are Wixen apples. They're very tiny, as you can see by the circles. They're on top of beet greens and a little lacinato kale, and then it's got an apple cider reduction. And on top is a citrus mostrada. So mostrada is basically a candied apple with mustard seeds and vinegar. So it's almost like a compote, very popular in Italy. So there you go. This, you know, winter is citrus season, so.
Can you shred that up?
The
mostrada?
It's actually, I have it's like a shredder.
It doesn't come that way, it's you shred.
No, you have to get the oranges, and that's about 6 oranges worth, and peel around, and I'll show it to you. Yeah, it's really cool. Okay?
Okay. Give me the key. Oh, it's incredible. It tastes so good. Very citrusy. Gotta try it.
This is why I'm
These are
to not have it during the service. So we paid for doing a sandwich.
Dear.
What's up next? So now we have our appetizer. This is sort of my raw modern take on a very old-fashioned recipe, oysters Rockerfella. So what we have here are oyster mushrooms, since we don't have real oysters, and if you do eat real oysters, they are in season now. So we have marinated oyster mushrooms. On top we have a spinach and artichoke topping. Traditional oysters Rockerfella, of course, has a spinach topping, and the topping was created by Chef Michael Brown over here. And we're serving with oyster crackers. It's on top of a bed of shredded fennel, and also puntarelle, which is sort of an Italian chicory that's in season for a very short amount of time. It has sort of a slightly bitter endive-like type flavor that I think meshes very well with the artichoke and spinach and chestnut also topping. So, enjoy.
Thank you.
So what you have is our version of turkey, with a manna bread stuffing. The cranberry sauce is cranberry, plum, orange, and sour cherry. Then you have shaved Brussels sprouts with chestnuts, a whipped cauliflower with some bacon bits, which you make from coconut, and sort of a lemon cream herb cream sauce for your gravy. And I notice it's a lot of food, so we do have take-home boxes for you. So if you can't finish it, we'll send you off with a doggy bag, okay? Because we still have dessert to go.
I'm really excited. This is my first raw vegan turkey. To give you guys an idea, this is called a turkey roll with manna bread, with some herb stuffing, shaved Brussels sprouts, chestnuts, and cauliflower. And that stuff right there on the top, you're looking at bacon bits. It's a little secret. I just discovered it's actually coconut, but it tastes like bacon somehow. I have no idea how they did that. Right there, you're looking at some jelly, cranberry, plum, orange, sour cherry sauce, and herbed butter gravy. Looks delicious, doesn't it? We're gonna give it a try right now. That's
dessert. We have a spice cake with a frozen pumpkin mousse, a vanilla panna cotta on top, sprinkled with just a little bit of nutmeg, and mission figs and calamari. I can't even talk. Yeah, calamari figs. Yeah, that's what they are.
Love it. I'm really proud that you guys are experimental, because that's what food is about. It's, you know, why have the same plebeian taste forever and ever?
Absolutely.
Beautiful room.
Very good.
Thank you.